that nothing can separate you and kingdom. That's what Paul says. Paul said, what can come between me and my God? Is it lack, sickness, diseases, bitterness, sorrow? Nothing. And that's how I look at it when people make excuses. That means you are not be connected to God. If you are connected to God, God will take number one.
Yes.
On the priority list, he will be number one. So, be kingdom addicted. And when you are kingdom addicted, you have to be a kingdom builder.
Hallelujah.
Tell you, say, be a kingdom builder.
Be a kingdom builder.
Be a kingdom builder.
Be a kingdom builder.
What is, how can someone build? Who are builders? Builders are those who that construct. Put it in together. And you cannot build without materials, resources. And you cannot build without a plan. There must be what we call external plan. Hello?
Aye.
No one can just say, oh, I want to put this one. That, no, no, it has to be approved. It has to be according to the specification of God. That is why your life has been designed according to the plan of God. There is no human being on earth without a purpose.
Yes.
Nobody. Even failure has a purpose. Uh-huh. Purpose to fail. But when you come to God, your failure becomes success.
Yes.
Bible says, let the weak say I am strong.
Yes.
Because when you are operating under the administration of God, all those negativity become positivity.
Yes.
All those inadequacies, all those things that is making people to say, impossible. This, Bible said to men, dear, it is impossible.
Possible.
But to me, God, all things
are possible.
Leaders cannot be without materials. You have to know what type of structure that you want to build. Someone can decide, I just want a ranch. Flat. Self-contained. Someone can say, no, I want a bi-level. Someone can say, I want a mansion. Hello?
Amen.
It depends according to how you want to build. Now, we are talking here of spiritual builders. Spiritual builders. Those who want to build the kingdom. Those who are ready. Who are ready? Because you cannot give any someone that is not experienced or is not ready to build. And say, can you just design me a mansion? He doesn't know anything about building. He doesn't know anything about plan to draw a plan of a house. Will you trust that person? So also God cannot entrust anything to the hand of someone who is not ready to be a builder spiritually. And a commission has been given unto you. You have been licensed to build. Tell yourself,
I have been licensed
to build.
Yeah.
And one thing you must know, if you cannot build your own life, how can you build the life of other people? Because you can only give out what you have. What when you don't have nothing, when you yourself are empty? What will you give out? Nothing. So let's quickly go to Mark 16. Are you there? 15 to 17. And then he told them, go into all the world and bring the good news to the everyone. Anyone who believes and is baptized will be saved. But anyone who refuses to believe will be condemned. Okay. If those ones have not been preached to, how are they going to be saved? How are they going to believe? Hello? That means there are some people's lives that have been tied to your own destiny. An assignment for you to deliver some people so that they will not be condemned. They say, they will cast out demons in my name and they will speak in new tongues. You have been licensed to deliver people. You have been licensed to bring good news to some people so that they can believe Jesus Christ. Now, they should preach the word and they don't believe, they will face condemnation and judgment. Then we will be free. But assuming you did not do it, what will happen? has given you the key to carry out this assignment. The key to do it. Say, I have the key.
I have the key.
When you have the master key in your hand, you can open any door. What does this scripture say? Matthew 16:19. I will give you the key to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth, which means when you go out to build, I will back you up. Whatever you say there, I will establish it. Because you are not doing it on your own accord. You are doing it on the accord of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. So when you decree something here, it has to be established here. Whatever you say yes to or not, is yes in heaven. And when you say no, it is no. Because you have been given the authority. When you have the license to practice, tell me, can anybody tell you cannot practice? Hello? When you have the license to carry out an assignment, when you get God's so good in America, everything you have certification. Able to go to the bathroom. Everything license, certification, license. So when God Himself satisfy you, empower you, giving you the key, what else do you want? When He said, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. When anyone wants to mess with you, you say, keep quiet. I am a shadow of the Most High God. Don't know whom I am. And God will say, yes. That's it. I back it up. You might say, wishes and wizards, hear the word of God. When you operate in this vicinity again, you become a dead dog. Do you think they will come? And thus we don't make use of the authority given unto us. Because we know we don't have a right relationship with God. When you don't have a right relationship with God, for you to exercise that authority, devil will accuse you. Then we say, you know what? I know John. I know Esther. Who are you? Devil is a liar. Yes. Because he's tormented. Yes. We are going to destroy his territory today in the name of Jesus. Yes. Now, key to the kingdom. My point of continuing today is that we have to reach out to the unbeliever. We have to reach out to the unchurched. We have to spread the good news. Because Jesus Christ is coming back very soon. He's coming back to take his people home. He's coming back. Those mansions he has gone to prepare. I know I'm going there to take occupancy. I'm going there to take occupancy. Some people will say, oh, we are okay, we here. I'm not okay here, I'm going there. And you know what? But Bible has explained it. Husband and wife will be in the bedroom, one will be calm, and one will still be watching TV. Praise God. Let's quickly go to Proverbs 11:30. Kingdom. Key to be the kingdom. Number one, wisdom. You must be wise. Where is God looking for wise people? Where is He not looking for fools? Hello. Who is reading? Don't worry. The seed of good things become a tree of life. A wise person win friends. Say, a wise person win friends. What of a fool? A fool person will not win souls. Which means a wise person is a soul winner. A wise person is a soul winner. And a fool will never win a soul. Now, if you are a wise person here, let me see your hands up. If you are wise, W-I-S-E, wise. Wise, with full of wisdom. Let me see your hands up. If you are a fool, is it not in the Bible? They say a wise person wins souls. And you now say, you are all wise. How many of you have been sold? I won souls in the last 1 month to this church. Spread the good news. Let me see your hands up.